We did a automatic lemonade pour or beer. I'm Trevor. This is
Tyler.
Tristan.
And then we made it so that it's an automated. So put your can down or your glass down, and then it automatically triggers the solenoid up there to drop down the can and puncture it pour into a cup. And then we also have a simulated refrigeration over here.
Ow.
So that's like, if we were pulling up, we'd have the cans up here refrigerated at all times, so stay cold. And put a cup on there, we'll run it. So now it's ready, and all we have to do is push the start button. And we have 15 seconds until can will drop and be a little low, here's some air. But then we just put the LEDs on for style. Bonus points. You can look good.
Who wants a fresh poured lemonade?
Yeah. Alright, what we got here is something a little bit more industrial. It is an automatic counter. What it's designed to do is it's designed to count anything that goes down the conveyor belt until it's reached a certain duration, at which point a simulated second conveyor will go off and then drag them away, assumably inside a bucket, so then you can automatically count things and then sort them. We added a couple of little features here. For example, one of these is a cooling fan, one of them is the simulated belt. This timer right here will be the thing keeping track for us, and this little thing right here will alert us automatically if any of the sensors aren't working, because it won't light up if anything goes by. I mean, it will stop lighting up if something goes by. Right here is also our automatic countdown, so then we are alerted when the machine is about to run, as well as the buzzer will go off immediately before the conveyor will go off. And this light will be blinking at all times while it is functioning, so that everyone is aware and doesn't get their hands stuck in it. With that, go ahead and start. Automatic countdown. As it goes off the last sensor is the one that's automatically detected it. The other two would be for if we have an additional function of some kind that you would like to include. As you can see, as it goes by each one, it automatically notices it here. And as it reaches the limit of 5, it immediately goes to the simulated second conveyor. Now, if also have an additional feature, just in case of emergencies. While the conveyor is running, at any point in time, someone can automatically press the reset button to forcefully shut it off in case of emergencies.
So we did a lift bridge. We used LEDs to simulate pretty much a stoplight in a way. We have green for go, which is always on when it's down. We have red for when it's up, and we have a blinking red light for our safety feature, which pretty much stops the whole thing. We also have these awesome neon lights that blink when the bridge is going up, so pretty cool. That's about it. Put it in action.
All right, here's the safety feature.
Basically, you open the door, trip the sensor, and the fan will kick on, pull the air in and out the pipe. So it basically just cleans the air and keeps cycling in.
Basically, what happens is you open the door and the motor goes off. This motor, you know, if you can find the project started. And as you trip this sensor here, you get a series of this fan coming out, this door opening, letting you know the air is coming out, you get it to go out. And it's a time delay for this motor to cut off, so it'll cut off in a second. And basically, that's pretty much the process of like coming in and out of the examination room. We use LEDs, a push button for the red button to start. Frequency drive, the buzzer. Also, we use these two motors, three-phase motors, and these 120-volt fans, and create our own like ventilation system. So it's kind of like the only neat project. Thank you.
All right, well, we have an elevator, five floors, LEDs for every floor wants to get on. Sensors on this side to show every floor you're on. And then when it passes the sensor, it's on floor one right now. So every time it passes the floor, it'll show you each floor it's on. So like if you press this one, it's going up to it. And then you press this, it'll go here, then go back down. And And good relaxing music. Oh yeah, and it'll pause every floor for like 4 seconds. So you can get on.
So we made a game. It's called Binary Beatdown. You count down from 9 and down to 0, one at a time.
In binary.
Yeah. And so we use switches to represent binary. Like 9, that's 1001. When the switch is on, it represents 1, off, 0. Every time we have to hit start to start the game, it counts up your 3 lives. It's the 3 mistakes you're allowed to make. Both players press start. And then as you go, you hit enter a 9, for instance, you start at 9. Yep, and then you input your number right here, and it takes you to the next sequence. And you go 9, 8, 7, 6, all the way down to 0. And then if you make a mistake, it blows air in your face, and a buzzer goes and then you lose life. And then when you lose all 3 lives, after making a mistake, the system, no matter what number you put in, locks itself up. No matter what. And then you reset your lives, comes back up. And when you win, we have a lovely and annoying fire alarm that goes off for a second. And whenever one player wins, it cuts out the whole system and resets the whole game. So we're going to play a sample game to test it out. We've played it so many times that we kind of used to it. I forgot about it. But then the fans go off for 10 seconds, and then after 10 seconds, everything resets.